Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
The cars are ready, the drivers are ready. We hope you're ready as qualifying is about to begin here in Bahrain. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
Qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Areno, Bottas and Daniel Ricciardo. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, it's goodbye.
I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
There's something in the Bahrain air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the sand. Our brightest minds have thrust their brightest ideas into the spotlight of the Sakhir circuit this evening as we look ahead once more to a Grand Prix that has thrilled us so consistently in the past. Formula One returns to the desert today on this exceptional 3.36-mile circuit. 15 corners provide plenty of overtaking opportunities, and two DRS zones will help with that as well. It could be a strategic race, this one, with Sakhir notorious for eating up the rear tyres. Watch out for drivers managing their rubber at some points during the Grand Prix. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're two very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help him improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day, and the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Renault in pole position then, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Hamilton, Kimi Raikkonen, and Hülkenberg, Rosberg, Vettel, Gutierrez, and Max Verstappen, Alonso, Grosjean, Kevin Magnussen, and Perez, Massa, Button, Carlos Sainz, and Daniel Kvyat, Wehrlein, and Harry Anto, Felipe Nasser, and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
We'll be right back.
Brilliant stuff from Renault today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
Here come today's winning drivers, and what a race it was! This is a team that knows success very well in F1, and they're just itching for even more. Congratulations to the Renault team for their excellent win today. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Let's give it to Kevin Magnussen. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.